Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to my channel Learn with Fun by Zarar sir. Today we'll be discussing about voltage division rule and let's understand what is voltage division rule. So it's a very simple concept. Assume I have a resistance over here as R1 and I have another resistance over here. Okay, I'll name it as R2. And suppose I have given as a voltage, total voltage as V over here. So if I need to calculate V1, which is voltage across R1, okay, and I need to calculate V2, which is voltage across R2. So what is the formula for calculation of such voltages? So if I have this total voltage as V, I need to calculate V1 and V2. This is a very simple way. V1 will be equal to, what is the voltage across V1? What is the resistance across V1? It is R1. So I'll write R1 upon R1 plus R2 into total voltage. In this way, you'll get V1. And the similar way, if I need to calculate V2, I'll write what is the resistance across V2 is R2. So I'll write R2 upon R1 plus R2 into total voltage. So this is a very simple way. Suppose I have been given an example, and I'll take this as an example. I have an R1 and R2 and the total voltage. So I have a total voltage of 6 volt. Assume I have a total voltage of 6 volts. I have two resistance. One is 1 ohm and another is 2 ohm. So I have total voltage as 6 volt and I need to calculate V1 and V2. So this will be my V1. And this will be my V2. So it's a very simple way. My V1 will be, what is the voltage, resistance across V1? It is 1 ohm. So 1 divided by 1 plus 2 into 6, which turns out to be 1 upon 3 into 6. And the final answer is 2 volt of V1. So the voltage across V1 is 2 volt. See, there is another way. I'll show you with an example. See, this is now if I need to calculate R2, it will be, if I need to calculate V2, it will be 2 upon 2 plus 1 or 1 plus 2 into 6. So it will be 3 1s are, 3 2s are, 2 2s are 4 volt. So as you can see, I have got two values, which is 2 volt and 4 volt. See, you might use this formula, V1 and V2. There's another way you can solve it if you use a simple common sense method. If I got the value of V1, suppose I got the value of V1, over here I got V1 as 2 volt and I need to calculate V2. So we also know V1 plus V2 is equal to total voltage. So if I need to calculate V2, it will be V minus V1. So you can use this also. If you have one voltage, you can calculate the other voltage using this also. This is basic fundamental, right? So it's a very simple. Suppose I have 6 volt, you can write 6 minus 4. So your V2 will be, V1 will be, if I did 6 minus 2, it will be 4. So V2 will be 4 volt. So it's another method. You can use this too. Okay, so it's a very simple. You have to just use this two formulae to calculate your V1 and V2. Okay. Now let's move to current division rule. Do remember, in voltage division rule, when we calculate V1, we considered R1. When we want to calculate V2, we have considered R2. Current division rule. So what is the difference between voltage division and current division rule? Suppose I have R1 over here and a resistance over here. I'll name it as R2. I have a current source of total current as I, and I need to calculate the current across R1 as I1, current across R2 as I2. So the basic difference between voltage division and current division is my I1 will be, you don't need to consider R1, you need to consider the other resistance, which is R2. So I'll write R2 upon R1 plus R2 into total current. So it's a little bit different from voltage division rule. In voltage division rule, we used to write V1 equal to R1. but in current division we write I1 equal to R2. Similarly, you can write I2 equal to R1 upon R1 plus R2 into total current. So it's a very simple way. While considering I1, you have to take R2. While considering R2, you have to take R1. Okay. So let's take an example. If I've taken example of, I'll assume the total current as 10 ampere, resistance as 2 ohm, and this resistance as 3 ohm. What will be my I1? So I1 will be, while considering I1, I have to take R2. So it will be 3 upon 3 plus 2 is 5 multiplied by total current. It's 10, 5 ones are, 5 twos are. I got 6 ampere as I1. If you want, you can use the same method to calculate I2, or you can subtract it from total current. So if I1 is 6, then I2 will be 10 minus 6, it will be 4. Or you can also use the another method. My I2 will be 2 upon total resistance is 5 multiplied by total current. 5 ones are, 2s are, this turns out to be 4 ampere. Okay, so it's a very simple way to calculate voltage division and current division rule. And this usually happens when students end up at Thevenin and Norton and they don't understand how to calculate voltage division and current division. So this is the best method they can use to solve voltage division rule and current division rule. So it's a very simple shortcut that you can use for voltage division rule and current division rule. Okay, hope you have enjoyed this. I have taught you voltage division and current division rule within 7 minutes. Okay, that's it. Thank you everyone. Like the video, subscribe to the channel and share this video. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.